Okay, so since these a lot of times deal with shapes, they don't have to be, but here's a fun one. They're talking about gravel being dumped from a conveyor belt. So, right, there's a conveyor belt, and it's kind of pouring off the end here. And the more gravel you dump, the bigger your pile gets, right? So I started out with this smaller one kind of inside to visualize, and later it will build up and up and up. It's going to get higher, but also if you think of the way just like a bunch of sand or something, if you just start dumping it, or gravel in this case, shit is shaped. It's like a cone, right? There's like a big pile. I mean, roughly it's going to fall kind of evenly across the thing unless there's like wind blowing or some other factors that they're not going to give us here. So they'll tell us a couple things about it. They say it's being dumped off at a rate of 40 cubic feet per minute. So that's how much is being poured off of the conveyor belt. So a volume. In fact, actually, in a little bit, or I guess now we could just remind ourselves. So if cubic feet is a volume, they just told you the rate of change of a volume. And like I said, with rate of change, it can also help to use your units. See how it's cubic feet per minute. So that tells us it's how fast the volume is changing with respect to time. So I know it's dV dt is 40. All right, so it forms a pile in the shape of a right circular cone, so a nice even cone. And cones, we usually care about two things on them, right? We measure the height and the radius, so how wide it is and how tall it is. All right, and then they say whose base diameter and height are always equal. So this is helping us. This just has to do with, I don't know, the weight of gravel or the way it spreads out. Instead of having a separate height and radius, we get to label them both the same. We get to call them both. And they say the base diameter is equal to the height. So be a little bit careful, like this whole distance across here, right? Not the radius and the height aren't equal to each other, the base diameter. Actually, my drawing's not so far off. That distance and that distance look kind of similar. Just visualizing what this might look like. So you have a couple options here. You can call each of these the radius, and you can say, oh, the height is the same as the diameter. So the height is the same as two radiuses. Or if you want to call it the height, then you'd have to go each of the radiuses is half of the height. If you get to pick and you get to avoid the fraction, I'd probably go with this version. So the height is the same as the diameter. The diameter is two radiuses. So right, this distance, this whole distance from here to here is the same as that. So that will save us some later when we start to do our calculations. And then their question is, how fast is the height of the pile increasing when the pile is 14 feet high? So specifically, we'll do a couple things. We can use H as our variable if we want to, but if we already went to R, we can just be careful that we're labeling well for the end of this. So their question is, how fast is the height of the pile increasing when the pile is 14 feet high? So they want to know how fast is the height increasing with respect to time. And specifically, they want to know it when the height is 14. Now, to be honest, this might change the way you want to label this. If it's going to bother you to have an H, like H in here, not in the other parts of it, we could redo this and we could call the height H, and then we could call each of the radiuses, we could call the radius half H. Or we could just go throughout and say, okay, when H is 14, right, when the height of the pile is 14, then the radius is 7, because these two things, right, one of them, the diameter is always equal to the height. So the radius is always half of the diameter. So you kind of have that relationship from the beginning. Totally up to you as you work through this. All right, so at first it doesn't feel like a lot of information, right? But we're still gonna have that like something we know, something we want to know, and we'll fill in the space in between. And so picture, even if they don't already from the beginning, kind of like the circle ones or the sphere ones, specifically mention it, we're probably gonna need to relate the volume. Because see how we have a speed for how fast the volume is changing? We're probably going to want to relate the volume to the height of a cone. So if we take what we know about cones universally, and you can look these things up, you don't have to have them memorized, but the volume of a cone is 1/3 pi r squared h. So 1/3 pi times the square of the radius times the height. So then up to us how we want to do our like substitution, how we want to name these here. Where there's an h, we could put 2r. Or if you notice, because they're asking a question about the height later, so you can answer this in terms of radius and then double it. Or if we want everything to line up nicely, just to the way they have this labeled, instead of calling this, we can say this is h and the radius is half the height, right? Since the diameter and the height are equal to each other. So totally up to you which substitution you want to go with. If you know, because we already set this up, that you're shooting for h's later, I'd probably maybe do this substitution. So where there used to be an r, we'll put 1/2 h. So just a quick, so we can get it down to one variable. It'll be easier to take our derivative. It'll make all our calculations easier later. So volume in terms of height of this particular cone. So now we're changing it to only cones whose height and base diameter are equal to each other. I don't have to put h to the first, but I'm gonna put it to remind myself here in a second when I try to simplify this a little. So 1/2 squared is 1/4, and I can also combine some variables here. So my 1/3 times 1/4 is 1/12. So we have 1/12 pi, and then h squared times h will be h to the third. So now we at least have an equation that relates the volume to the height of this thing. And also picture what our kind of end goal might be, and maybe we'll fill these in later when we find them. See how we know dv dt, right? We already have this piece of information. And so what could our missing link be to get between h and dh dt and dv dt? So we know this, we want to know this. So we want to start with an h and we want to end with a t. See how dv is the thing we need to cancel out? So our goal here is we want to know this equation. How fast is the height changing with respect to volume? So if we have an equation that relates height and volume, which we do, right, we just came up with, if we take the derivative of that, we could come up with either dv dh, how fast is the volume changing with respect to height? Or if we take the reciprocal, we could get dh dv, how fast is the height changing when you change the volume? Right? They depend on each other, so you can go either direction. Like a taller pile has more in it, and a pile with more in it is going to be taller, right? That like relationship works both ways. So it doesn't even matter really what this equation looks like. So we'll take this equation here, and it's probably easier at first to come up with the derivative with respect to h, just because that's the way the equation solved. If it bothers you to do this, you could solve it for h and then take the derivative. But it's usually easier to take the derivative and then worry about the reciprocal afterwards. All right, so dv dh. Notice it looks like a lot, but most of this is constants. It's 1/12 pi is a constant. So really, we're just asking what's the derivative of h to the third, which is 3h squared. So times 3, right? 3 times 1/12 is 3/12. We'll worry about simplifying it a little bit. So 3h squared is the derivative of h to the third. And so if we reduce this, it's 1/4 pi h squared. Or pi over 4 if you want to write it that way. All right, so notice that's dv dh. We technically wanted dh dv. This is why labeling is so important. Dh dv, which is the reciprocal of this one. So we can flip it. We could call it 4 over pi and 1 over h squared. Or if you want to keep the whole thing looking like one equation together, you're going to use it for such a short period of time. You can do that too if you want. Either way is going to get you the same thing. All right, so let's see if we have everything to answer the question now. We have the piece that we want, right? We have something we can plug in the rate of change of the height with respect to volume. We know dh dv. We know that dv dt is 40, right? They told us that in the setup of the problem. So we should be able to plug in all that information and get our final answer here. dh dt, and in a little bit we'll do when h is 14 is this 1 over pi over 4h squared, and we know we're plugging in h is 14, so 14 squared times dv dt, which from the beginning of the problem was 40, right? So this piece of information that we calculated times this piece of information should get us there. So that looks like 40 divided by pi over 4 times 14 squared. Get my calculator. These are real life problems, so that's why they're okay with decimal answers. Are perfectly fine. But if you want to turn this into a decimal, you certainly don't have to do it by hand. So 40 over 1/4 pi times 14 squared, or 14 times 14, is approximately 0.2598. And if we want to throw a measure on that, notice since originally they told us this in cubic feet per minute, this is how fast the height of the pile is changing. So a height is just in feet per minute. And you can also, you can do this in some of them more than others, depending on what they're talking about. Like the ones with cars, you can see if the speed makes sense to you. But even in this one, picture you're dumping 40 cubic feet a minute on the pile. The pile's already pretty big. It's 14 feet tall. So as it gets bigger, you have to pour more and more and more on to make a difference in the height at the very top of that cone. And so you're getting a quarter of a foot per minute. I mean, it may be like, why would you want to know this? Maybe it's like your lunch break and you're like, can I leave this pile for 30 minutes? Or is the pile going to get taller than the conveyor belt? And, you know, I don't know, become dangerous and tip over or get fired or something, something in this imaginary scenario. But so no, you know at that point. And actually, it's only going to slow down from there. So if you did it at another point, like if we plugged in 20 for the height, this would get smaller, right? You notice that 14 was in the denominator. So at the moment, it's growing a quarter of a foot per minute. The bigger the pile gets, it's only going to slow down. And a smaller pile, it would definitely be faster, right? The pile's not as big, so the height is building up a lot quicker. So, but we're still using that. Something we know, something we want to know, and we bridge the gap between those is where most of the calculation happens at.